I'm back out here.
Christy and I have a little something.
I'm already starting.
No,
come on over here.
Come here. Come here. Come here. I'm gonna get teary nose here.
It was your dream to have Chloe walk down the aisle with you. She can't. So
this is kind of the next best thing. And we figured you could tie it in with your flowers, so then you really are carrying her.
Look very closely at the little details.
We've got a little Jew star. We've got her first stone in a little,
yeah, in a little bone.
And a little picture.
It's a, you could be a necklace, it could be anything. It could be.
Alright, ugly crying!
So that way Chloe walks with you.
And Mama's crying too.
Okay, let's just get it out of our system now.
And your mom has known about this the whole time.
Oh, I love it.
So it is a necklace.
Yeah.
But we figured we can take off the metal part and then we can tie this into your bouquet. And we can hide it or you can pull it out if you want to look at it too. So
I think every time I look at it, I'll start crying.
You remember when we started talking about it, we're like, we have to find something Jewish to put in there.
Yeah, and my friend sells these and I contacted her and she was like, oh yes, we do. So
see it?
Yeah. She's seen pictures.
Hello, Jewy Jew.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
And Chrissy gave me some of your favorite pictures of Chloe to pick.
I didn't know they could actually put pictures. I will, Mom. We're just
Michelle did that.
I did that.
Michelle did that.
It was
just clear.
Yeah. So you can pull the picture out if you don't want, or if you want to put a different one in of her, you can do that too.
So, so Chloe can be at our wedding.
That's why we're doing this now?
Yeah, so you can have some time to
get this shit together.
And then while we're doing...
You too.
While we're doing...
I saw it. Because Christy had it there. It's in the picture, yeah.
This was also something before. This is not from... This is from...
Oh! I actually thought of something. Oh no, is there a note in here that's going to make me cry? Okay. Oh, my hand again, a little jiggly. Oh! Oh, that's pretty.
But this is a real for real one.
Oh, the chain's gorgeous.
Not a cheap Walmart one.
It's beautiful. Aww. Okay.
Okay. I'll get myself all going here.
Okay. Okay, so we're in this necklace then. Mama, you
and family. Please be seated.
We have joined here today to share with Terry and Garrett an important moment in their lives. Over the last 4 years, we have seen their love and understanding grow and flourish, and now they have decided to publicly confirm their commitment to one another. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is standing together and facing the world. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, but the right partner. And if you would look each other in the eyes. That I do not know of any unlawful impediment.
That I do not know of any unlawful
impediment. Why I, Gareth David Moore.
Why I, Gareth David Moore.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Terry Ann Milani.
Terry Ann Milani.
And Terry, if you would please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I do not know of any unlawful impediment.
That I do not know of any unlawful impediment.
Why I, Terry Ann Milani.
Why I, Terry Ann Milani.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Gareth David Moore.
To Gareth David Moore.
And now for the vows. Gareth, if you would please repeat after me. I, Gareth David Moore.
I, Gareth David Moore.
Take you, Terry Ann Milani. To be my beloved wife.
To be my beloved wife.
To have and to hold you.
To have and to hold you.
To treasure you.
To treasure you.
To be by your side in sorrow and in joy.
To be by your side in sorrow and in joy.
And to love and cherish you always.
And to love and cherish you always.
I promise you this from my heart.
I promise you this from my heart.
For all the days of my life.
For all the days of my life.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Gareth David Moore.
To witness that I, Gareth David Moore.
Do take thee, Terry Ann Milani.
Do take thee, Terry Ann Milani.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
And Terry, please repeat after me. I, Terry Ann Milani.
I, Terry Ann Milani.
Take you, Gareth David Moore.
Take you, Gareth David Moore.
To be my beloved husband.
To be my beloved husband.
To have and to hold you.
To have and to hold you.
To honor and respect you.
To honor and respect you.
To treasure you.
To treasure you.
To be at your side in sorrow and in joy.
To be at your side in sorrow and in joy.
And to love and cherish you always.
And to love and cherish you always.
I promise you this from my heart.
I promise you this from my heart.
For all the days of my life.
For all the days of my life.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Terry Ann Milani.
To witness that I, Terry Ann Milani.
Do take thee, Gareth David Moore.
Do you take thee, Gareth David Moore.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Gareth, if you would please place this ring on Terry Ann's finger and repeat after me. This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
As a token of my love and devotion.
A token of my love and devotion.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
I choose you to be my wife.
I choose you to be my wife.
This day and forevermore.
This day and forevermore.
This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
As a token. my love and devotion.
As a token of my love and devotion.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
I choose you to be my husband.
I choose you to be my husband.
This day and forevermore.
This day and forevermore.
I'd now like to call upon the matron of honor and the father of the groom to join Gareth and Terry Ann for the signing of their marriage license.
I've seen Terry Ann grow into the beautiful, caring woman that you are today. I'm happy that you found your aimless prince, Gareth. Gareth, you're a great guy, sir. I just wish that I could understand what you say when you talk to me. Just kidding, Gareth, because I get teased a lot about the way I talk. Right, Mark? Tyrion, my beautiful princess, Tika. Love you lots, so very happy for both of you here on your special day.
Your son
for not planning. I know, otherwise I would have wrote something down. But any case, I wasn't a bit perplexed when I heard Tyler saying that you've got to be weird. Now, I've never thought of the Moore family as being weird. So, I don't know. Possibly we are, I've never realised. Well, I'm very happy that Terry has joined the Vaughan clan. She's a beautiful girl, and I'm very happy for Garrett. It's about time he got something right. Terry's family's fantastic. Brother, Jim, father, I should say, auntie and uncle. They all look after me when I'm here. And Susan, of course. So, I'd just like to wish you all the best. Great to have you on board. And don't ever ask me to do another speech. Thank you.
Those of you who don't know me, I'm Tarianne's matron of honor and much, much, much younger sister. I will apologize now, Tarianne. You worked so hard to drop the Anne, but I just can't do it. You'll always be Tarianne to me. Growing up, she always hated being called Tarianne, and every time I would call Tarianne, I would get a snarky Chrissy Anne back in return. When she moved to Winnipeg from Thunder Bay, it was her chance for a fresh start. She could now just be Terry until she decided that I should start meeting her new friends when I would visit. So I am sorry, and you are now Terry Ann to everybody. I would like to start off by saying just how stunningly gorgeous you do look tonight, Terry Ann. There is definitely one lucky man, and I would like us to all raise our glasses to celebrate the beautiful bride. I have literally known Tarianne my entire life, and once upon a time, I actually looked up to her, literally. We've seen each other at our best and at our worst. We have fought, laughed, cried, fought, hugged, fought, kept each other's secrets, fought. But through it all, we have always been there for each other, and always will be. I love our silly inside jokes, most of which revolve around making fun of Mom. And I love that we still have our secret little language that to this day Mom still can't figure out. And for the last time here, we will not teach you our secret language. I do love how our relationship has evolved over the years, from just big sister and little sister to genuine best friends. And there's no two sisters who love each other more. Over the years, I've seen Tarianne get her heart broken many times, but I knew there was something different when she met this Garrett fellow. I remember grilling her over the phone about this new guy she met. Living in separate provinces, it is hard to tell if someone was right for my sister without meeting them in person, but I could hear it in her voice that she was smitten. Considering that I have never liked any of her boyfriends up until then, Gareth had a lot to prove whether he knew it or not. He was very warm and welcoming the very first time we met, and he won me over right away. I remember them coming to visit Mark and I for Thanksgiving weekend, and he was so helpful and considerate. I told Tarianne right away that he was a good catch. It means the world to me that my sister has finally found her happy ending. Anyone who knows Terry Ann knows that she loves love. The cheesier, more romantic, the better. I'm talking roses, candlelight, slow dancing, love notes, picnics, surprise getaways, holding hands, gazing out the stars. You writing this down, Jared? Along with Terry Ann's love of romance was the love of all things Disney. Aladdin, Lion King, Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, Lady and the Tramp, Bambi. If there's a love story in Cash tunes, she's all about it. Taryn also loves to belt out random Disney tunes anytime, any place. So I thought I would finish the rest of my speech in true Terry Ann style.
Oh, you're the thing?
Oh. As the two of you embark on a whole new world, I wish you no worries for the rest of your days. Even though he's a tramp, just let it go, because some people are worth melting for. In this circle of life, just keep swimming and reach for the sky. Always remember, sis, that you've got a friend in me, and you'll be in my heart. So this is love, a tale as old as time. Our beauty has found her beast. The dream is a wish your heart makes, and love is a song that never ends. We can all feel the love here tonight. So before I bore these poor unfortunate souls any further, I would like to say thank you, Terry Ann and Gareth, for allowing us all to be part of your world. And may you live happily ever after. Now, Gareth, what are you waiting for? Kiss the girl.
Thanks for the introduction, Tyler. I appreciate you. But for those of you who are wondering why there are three best men standing up here, it's perfectly simple. Gareth wanted to appoint a best man for the occasion, but sadly he couldn't find one, so he got the three barely competent ones instead.
All right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Some of you are probably wondering who I am. I'm Terry Ann's brother-in-law, Marcus Steed, and Gareth, I'm Sparky. I've known Mary Ann since I was 16 years old, at a place I like to call Dairy Queen, home of the breeder bird with potties and cool treats. But I've known Gareth for about 4 long years. On Thanksgiving, long weekend, meeting for the first time, and he was thrilled about his intentions with my little big sister. He passed the test. When Gareth asked me to be part of, to be his best man, I was obviously flattered, but then I realized I would have to give a speech. And at some point during it, I would have to say something nice about Julia. The problem is, I have little experience with doing either, so please bear with me. As a current favorite son-in-law, I thought I would pass on some tips on how to keep Mark, Chris, and Harry Ann happy. Because if one of these girls, they will all be happy. Because these three are a package deal. Number one, mother knows best. Show her respect. You want her approval. No one to shut up. Trust her opinion. Number two, happy wife, happy life. Always make Terry Ann your priority. You are now always second place. Number three, accept that you will always be outnumbered. Number four, always make time for them. Number five, if they are quiet, be afraid. Number six, buy bigger clothes. These ladies will fatten you up. They love to cook, but then again, they love to eat. Gareth, go Gary, G. You now have a beautiful, talented partner for life. Someone to share the highs and bring comfort during the lows. Someone who makes each day worth living and a source of many wonderful memories for years to come. And Terry Ann, you now have a really nice ring. There's no doubt that marriage is a special thing. It's supposed to be wonderful and simple, and that's exactly what we have here today. Terry Ann is wonderful, and Gary is simple. Gareth was born in England on January 27, 1981. I wanted to link his birthday to some major world event, but it seems that nothing of importance happened that day. Although, the staff in the hospital still refer to this day as Ugly Wednesday. Bazinga! All joking aside, Gareth, I want to say what a privilege it is to stand up and support you and Carrie Ann on your special day. Gareth and Carrie Ann, I wish you very best for your future. Everyone, raise your glass to life, to love, life, laughter, and happily ever after.
Cheers.
I've known Gareth for the past 4 years, and it has been a very interesting ride and adventure. From discovering snowboarding with Corey, to numerous obstacle mud runs, as three middle-aged men to embark on a gravity loaded and always painful when you fall down a sport, we all have numerous injuries amongst us. Gareth is always the first to say, "Hey guys, have you seen this? We should do this. Ducky, go first! If you survive, I'll do it!" He's always the first to suggest the activity, but prefers to be second or third crash test dummy. One more memory I have with him is we went to a gun adventure park. We were in the climbing tower, and I got caught up in a cargo net, and I tripped upside down. Instead of coming to my aid and helping me out of the net, he ran over to the edge and yelled, "Terry, get a picture of Ducky. He's stuck in the net." That was Gareth trying to be supportive in his own twisted way. Another time we were at a cottage, and I had bought a slack line. Gareth was so excited that we had a few drinks first, before trying to balance on a 2-inch tightrope. We kept falling off. Terry was worried that somebody was going to get hurt, as the hospital was an hour and 45 minutes away. So we decided to sit on the slack line, balance ourselves on our butt cheeks, and drink our beer with no feet touching the ground. I fell off, hit my head, but did not spill a drop. Gareth and I celebrated with an impromptu interpretive dance to the Little Mermaid, Part of Your World. And yes, a video does exist. A wise one. A wise person once said that magic happens at the most unexpected moments. I would have to disagree. Today has been planned for months and months, and it is still filled with magic. I've known Gareth for 4 years, and I've never seen him happier than when he is with Terry. And I haven't seen Terry without a smile when she and Gareth are together. Sunscreen. The magic that makes him happy today is love. Love, however, isn't always simple. You will fight and disagree. But as long as you love each other, this magic will never die. May the rest of your lives be filled with magical moments. Congratulations to you both, and I love you guys.
Terry first, and then Gareth had a team on the scene.
kind of a shy, nervous kind of person, so being here kind of odd. He's had a GQ tank shirt and that word said. I didn't know about this guy, if he was going to be friends or not, but then they invited him to snowboarding. And I was like, okay, we'll be fine. So as we went, we kind of went in, and they said, come on, I'll hold your hand, we'll go take lessons. And I'm like, oh, I feel like a little kid again. If I was even a little shorter, I'd probably come home and sleep. Just like, I can be sure. And so we kind of went on, and my hand way back. Felt kind of good. Sorry. But then as you get to know, we kind of go to this place and pick him up. And every time we went, I'd be a little bit nervous, so I check myself a little bit loosely. I'm a little bit digestive, and so, okay, we're good, let's go. Then it's like, we're going late. So we get there, and here, where is he? And Sarah would be like, this way, he's coming. Well, where is he? He's Texas digestive. I'm like, ooh, I like this guy. Yeah, I'm Texas digestive stuff too. So over the years, the world works and stuff like this. He decided to try some DIY, or DIY, sorry. So a little DIY, a little bit of weekend warrior, I want to put all the crap in the side of the house. I'm like, okay, sounds good. So the room, he called me, picked up a little bit of ceiling and stuff like this. Now I know it's a little bit sticky. So we did a couple of minutes, and he tried a couple of times, and I said, you gotta hang on and say, I'm good, I'm good. So all of a sudden, I have, okay, I got the home and stuff like this, and so I got home and all of a sudden I got a text message. It's Terry. So, how do you get that ceiling off here? Never mind, how do you get that ceiling off the door? Never mind, how do you get that ceiling off the wall? The shower, the sink, the faucets, clothing. Pretty much everything that could possibly touch in that house was touched by here. And I never laughed so hard in my life, trying to pass. Never laughed so hard. I thought, yeah, this guy's for real. But I think the most part, the biggest part I have become kind of friends with Gary is at a certain time, many years ago, we were kind of at a we were supposed to be going to Assisi ski resort, and it turned out to be really, really cold and really, really snowy. So we ended up not going that particular weekend. And so all of a sudden, I get this post saying, hey, you should check this YouTube video. And I said, YouTube, I never go on YouTube. And so all of a sudden, it says, here's, what is it? Hulk Media from St. Patel. No. Okay. So I checked this thing out. I'll let a friend lift me up. So I think this is the video. And all of a sudden there's Garrett. And he has a face mask. And it's, I don't know if anybody's ever seen it, it's Hulk Hogan's mustache from wrestling, WWE wrestling. And he's wearing his wrestling face mask with a tube. And all of a sudden the Hulk Mania theme song comes on. And he starts flexing. And doing the call, and I think he even picked up the dog and started getting big. And thought, oh yeah, this guy is kind of a weirdo. And then, I was just mentioned, yeah, our whole friends are weirdos. I'm like, yeah, this is the weirdo for me. And I knew our friendships were cemented that day. So I decided to let Trey and you know. So I think we the video, of course. So we can get here without here. We even bought, we didn't bring his face mask, but we bought the particular mustaches. And you play a game. There we go.
Chrissy, I never could have dreamed of a better best friend. Part of it, you were always stuck with me, and the other part, we learned to grow to love each other unconditionally. I think I would have lost it throughout this planning without your help, guidance, suggestions, and most of all, patience. Mark, I did pick you right from the start. Don't ever forget that. You've been an absolutely amazing brother. I want to be yours and yours friends. I love, love, love Chrissy and Mark together and always have. Sue and David, thank you for accepting me with open arms into your family and making me special from day one. I'm grateful to have another set of parents to try and keep me in line. Joe and Matt, you've also become very important to me, and I love that you're part of my new family.
Yeah, she was that mother. I'm certain in a lot of cases that they only want to speak over so they could be mothered by you. Your generosity, kind heart, and constant smile cannot be challenged. Love you, Mom. Father, without you, I don't think I would achieve the work ethic, ambition, achievements I have today. Everyone says you and I are such alike, but the truth is, I'd be proud to be called the amazing guy you truly are. Please stand up and raise your glasses to the parents and family.
For a good life today, and we want to thank all of you who are here tonight. You made the cut. When we first started planning the wedding, Gareth and I kept butting heads. I wanted to add more guests, and he kept wanting to take more away. At the end of the day, the right people are here with us today, and we wouldn't have it any other way. Firstly, we'd like to take the time to acknowledge our out-of-town guests who made the time and paid the price to be here today. A huge thank you to Susan and David, Mom and Dad Mark, Gareth's sister Jo and her husband Matt, Gareth's aunt and uncle, Jean and Tony. As well, I'd like to thank Tyler, also from England now, Soggy England. I'd also like to thank my sister, her husband Mark, along with my cousin Michelle and her boyfriend Daniel, for coming through my hometown another day. Now on to our help. Thank you ever so much to Brian. He made the beautiful wooden centerpieces as well as our cake stand, and you helped forever a dream come true and vision that I had in my head. Kay, you worked your butt off. Kay helped with pretty much all of my decorations, and not once did you make my ideas feel weird or woolly or unattainable, and our new friendship is what made it worth it all in the end. Lee? Yeah, you. We didn't want to burden you with the task of music and sound, etc. And you can't forget about the right-hand man, Craig. You both have been fantastic. Above and beyond and always, helping with this as well as keeping both of us sane. And just being supportive friends right from day one. I can't thank you enough for that.
Thank you.
Tyler, the little brother I never had, until Mark, of course. I love you dearly. Can't thank you enough for making our ceremony that much more special. It's just made it more personal and everything I wanted. Our bridal party, each and every one of you, have put up with so much, good, bad, and the ugly, from both of us at very different times. We feel lost completely with all of you if you were missing from our journey of life. Thank you for your support, your muscle, and help wrapping for the wedding and on a regular basis, as well as everyone putting up with my groomzilla.
Where is?
the rest of the world, the rest of the world, the rest of the world, the rest of the world.